Detailers can use Revit to create a coordinated and constructible model that contains level of detail 400 content from the Autodesk Fabrication products. To get started, open the MEP Fabrication Parts browser. Select a service and a group to view the available content. To access the content, a fabrication configuration must be installed and fabrication services must be loaded into the model. Refer to the Revit 2016 help for more information on specifying fabrication content. To place fabrication parts, select a part and move to the drawing area to place it. Begin by placing a tap. To position the tap, press the space bar to rotate it around the duct. Press Shift and the space bar to rotate it around its connector. Next, place a straight. Notice that when you place a part, it is automatically sized to match the connecting part. Enable smart snapping to increase the snap target on connectors to make it easier to connect parts. A fabrication layout may contain design intent Revit elements, as well as detailed level fabrication parts. You can connect a Revit family element, such as the fan coil unit, directly to a duct fabrication part. Next, place a transition. To modify the dimensions for the transition, click Edit Part. As you edit the values, you can apply and preview the changes before clicking OK to save the changes to the model. Place a straight and then place a T. To toggle the connector end for the T, press the up arrow key. In the Parts browser, switch the service from ductwork to piping and place a pipe on the fan coil unit. Use the product entry field in the properties palette to view the available pipe sizes. The product entry list is a catalog of available sizes for purchased parts, such as certain duct fittings and most piping parts. Select the short radius elbow and notice that it displays an arrow. This indicates that different parts are available depending on the size. For example, one material is used up to a certain size elbow and a different material is used above that size. In this example, the copper elbow is automatically placed. Press the space bar to rotate the elbow in 45-degree increments. Place another pipe and another short radius elbow. Select the elbow and this time use the rotate control in the drawing area to rotate the bend in 45-degree increments. Next, place a longer horizontal pipe. To place hangers on piping runs, select the hangers group and select a hanger. Position the cursor along the edge or center line of a straight segment. To place hangers on ductwork, change the service and group and then select a hanger. By default, hangers are attached to the closest structure element. Structure categories include floor, roof, structure framing, such as a beam or truss, stairs, and slabs. If no structure element is available, Revit uses the default rod length as set in the ITM file definition. When you use Revit to model a fabrication layout, you can achieve a higher level of development.